Okay, here's a question for you. When is the last time your child got their hands on toys, actual toys? I'm not talking about the game on the iPad. I'm talking about charts and things you hold and things you do. Well, there's a store called Happy Up Toys, and they want you to come in right before the school year to find out all these great hands-on things. Say hi to Shantae Ray. She's from Happy Up Inc. They're in Clayton, Maryland Plaza in Clayton, correct?
Maryland Avenue.
Maryland Avenue, there you go. Yep. And we're talking about, now I know Toys R Us went out of business, so toy stores are I don't know, are they becoming sort of a thing of the past, do you think?
No, I think they're becoming a thing of the future.
There you go.
All of a sudden, we have special attention, we know everything we sell, we play with everything when you come in, we'll open boxes for you, and then we will wrap your gifts for free.
I love that part.
I mean, it makes it super easy.
Well, let's talk about technology versus hands-on. It's always been about child development and getting your hands on things and fitting the puzzle pieces where they need to go.
Right.
Do you find that you're fighting that battle with technology?
Absolutely. We all are at our homes. You know, everyone wants, all the kids want to have their iPads and they want to be on a laptop or a computer or on their Xbox or whatever it is that they have. But some things are missing with manual dexterity and with logic. Teachers love it when a kid's been exposed to logic puzzles and things like that, because all of a sudden they're learning to solve problems.
And you know what? That sounds like a great thing. School's starting up again in a few weeks, so maybe if moms and dads want to come in and show us a few of the things you have there at Happy Up.
So another thing that becomes an issue as school starts is time management. And so I have a good old-fashioned chore chart where you just lay out what kids need to do every
day. Water the plants. No whining. I like that one. We could use that in the newsroom.
Right, exactly. And so it's a simple thing. Sometimes it doesn't have to be super complicated. And you know, when kids are sitting at the table eating cereal, sometimes they just need to be staring at their math facts. It doesn't have to be complicated.
Just the basics.
The back of this is dry erase, so then they can practice what they've learned. But the more you can put it in front of them, the better. These are just $3.99, super easy.
I love these little timers you mentioned.
Yeah.
Those are great.
This is a little sight word game that's really simple. You pull a popcorn and you try to read.
Must. Us.
You're so good at this.
Thank you. Thank you.
And so sometimes you're just trying to make mundane things a little more exciting and a little more fun.
All right, let's talk about homework time. It can mean stress for the kid and the parent.
It totally can. So these are
called heavy-ish.
Manimo. This one weighs about 4 pounds or so. And so the idea is that when you need to calm down, you need to focus on your homework, you need to focus on whatever you're doing. These can be put on your shoulder, and anytime you put them on, you just feel sort of peaceful.
Yeah, it calms you a little bit.
They can be put on your thighs, and they're really helpful. We're really in love with them.
I love this. This is sort of like a mini flashcard kind of thing where you can actually write on it.
Right, so it's visual. So they give you two animals, which makes it a little more fun, and then they tell you what the number function is, and then when you need to count them, when they're very first learning to add, you can count up the spaces to get the answer, so it's super visual. So sometimes it gets over that hump of the basic mathematical understanding with visual and writing and lots of
layers.
That's
awesome. And we did talk about technology. I mean, iPads are different, but this is really, really neat. Tell us what that's all about.
So this is called Circuit Scribe. And what this is it's an electronic conductive pen that writes very smoothly. It's not chunky. And what happens is when you connect the circuits, this acts like a wire. And you turn it on and we've made a little circuit.
They connect them. Yeah, that's really cool. So yeah, whatever happened to that, right? Bring the kids back to the way it was back in the day. Get them ready for school. Again, it's starting up in a few weeks, so you might want to go visit them at Happy Up Maryland Avenue in Clayton. So check it out. This is great. Go say hi to Shantae. She'll be there for you. Maybe a nice gift. They gift wrap for free. Remember? All right, it'll get your kids started. And their website is called happyupinc.com. All right, we'll take a break and be back.